Jesus and John the Baptist, we are, you know, contemporary. They live at the same time, in the same period. They preach in the same period, to the extent that John the Baptist even baptized Jesus in River Jordan. They were contemporaneous, meaning they lived together at the same time. They grew up together. Even the mother of John the Baptist, you know, was a sister to the mother of Jesus, Mary. Elizabeth, called Asia. You know, they were all together from the same family. So Jesus and John the Baptist lived at the same time. But up to the time of John the Baptist and Jesus, alayhi salam, the Jews were asking this question. Are you the Christ? John the Baptist said no. Okay. Are you Elijah? John the Baptist said no. Are you then that prophet? When you read any Bible, in the footnote, you will see they refer that prophet to be the prophet mentioned in Deuteronomy 18:18. This prophecy was made in the lifetime of Moses, alayhi salam, about the coming of that prophet like Moses. But up to the time of Jesus and John the Baptist, they were still asking questions about that prophet. They asked John the Baptist, are you the Christ? He said no. Are you Elijah? He said no. Are you then that prophet? Three different questions. Are you Mr. A? No. Then, are you then Mr. B that we are expecting? No. What then? Are you then that Mr. C? No. Three different questions. As they questioned John the Baptist, that if you are not the Christ, no Elijah, no that prophet, why don't you baptize? John chapter 1 verses 19 to 21 and John chapter 1 verse 25. And he denied. When Jesus Christ came, then they recognized Jesus Christ through his miracles. At that time when they were asking John the Baptist, Jesus was already there, but they could not recognize him. They recognized Jesus alayhi salam to be the Messiah that was to come. But they told Jesus that Elijah is supposed to have come before me. Jesus said, of course Elijah is supposed to come before me. But Elijah is already here with you, but you misunderstood him. Matthew chapter 17, verses 10 to 13. You know him not. It was here that they understood that Jesus spoke unto them of John the Baptist. In Luke 1, 17, he also pointed to John the Baptist. He said, this is Elijah. If you will receive him. This is the person that came in the spirit and power of what? Of Elijah. You know? So it was even in the lifetime of Jesus, alayhi salam, in his full maturity, that John the Baptist was assassinated. It was in his time that John the Baptist was incarcerated by King Herod. He was put in prison by King Herod. Jesus was very much aware and Jesus was alive, you know, and John the Baptist even baptized him. Now out of the three questions, how many questions have been solved? Two questions. Remember one question, are you then that prophet? If there was no prophet to come after Jesus, Jesus wouldn't have prophesied about the coming of the Spirit of Truth, the Comforter, the Counselor, the Helper, the Paracletos, the advocate who will guide the world into all the truth. It is not a mere coincidence. It was only a chain of prophethood from Adam alayhi salam to Jesus and finally to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If there was no any other revelation to be sent, the Bible wouldn't have said that we know in part and we prophesy in part, but when that which is perfect comes, the incomplete one will be kept aside. So all these things we are going to look at them in the light of the truth. So may the Almighty Allah bless us. May Allah have mercy on us. May Allah forgive us our shortcomings. May Allah accept our act of ibadah. May Allah help and assist all those that contributed towards the propagation of Islam. All those that contributed with their money, those that contributed with their knowledge, those that contributed with their provision in the form of food, you know, and dreams. May the Almighty Allah continue to take care of them. May Allah continue to open their way of success. May the Almighty Allah give them good children that have the fear of the Almighty Allah. May Allah continue to bless the effort of the IPC and all other Islamic propagation centers throughout the world. It was just yesterday that I received a message. They are there in Adamawa, delivering tafsir with the national leader of the Izala, London, Sheikh Balano, A. Balano. So he called us and said that Balano said we should tell the IPC please to pray for the success of General Muhammadu Buhari and also for peace to reign in our country. And he said he is also greeting all the Muslims, not only here, but the Muslims all over the East. That was the message. It was not the Balano that spoke to me directly, but Balano passed the message to Anarama Nasiru Gondu, and Nasiru Gondu passed the message. So I promise that when we come in the morning, inshallah, I will deliver this message. Okay.
Wa alaikum salam. Just three questions. Number one, how can we get access to that gospel of Barnabas? Number two, what is that difference between John the Baptist and Elijah? Or is actually the John the Baptist the Elijah?
Yeah.
So then, thirdly, just like you said, I want to point out that in our Tarawih, we should be doing that kunut. Because over times now, they have not been doing the kunut. And I spoke with the Malam, he said the most of time. But I said, okay, even if it is just a minute, now we have to what we have spent. But the most of Ramadan is the most of Dua. And truly, truly, if you are the one that be observing very well, you will see that in every ramifications, those people who dispute what the administrator of Buhari that time, they know who he is and they know what he can do, even though they are not God. But he has told it before, he has a precedent that he cannot say no. And this what they are living upon. This is why you call them fellowship.